When you get your mould, you'll be able to make some beautiful finished tiles that look like this one here in this picture, that you can actually cement into your walls. So that would be nice for you to have something to take away and use. I hope it will work out for you.
And we all get told here, actually, stretch and
bottle it. I'm going to show you three stages to this. First of all, you centre the clay. It's really hard to do.
Well, anybody know what lime is at all? It's like a white powder that you put into it. What it does, it gives it wettability and it also makes it all nice together.
But basically you centre, then basically you hollow it out, you make a hole in it, and the third one is you pull up the wall. So there's three stages.
You won't be told, I can turn to it,
on this portion of the wheel, you put your tools and all your handwork between 12 o'clock and 6 o'clock. If you go to that side, everything drives the wrong way round. You have to be on the right.
What I'm going to do, basically, is get your trowel, just give it a few sort of like, a dry mixing of it to get it all nice and workable again.
If you don't do this, then your clay will slide off and it'll end up there.
This is what we call a gauge rod or a gauge lap. What we've got some spacing on the gauge lap, and they're 75mm back, and each brick is 65mm high. So what it's going to do, it's going to correspond to each map, it will give 10mm venture for another brick. What we're going to do now is cracked yourself across, you know what I've been doing. Like so. And I'm going to place that one to there. Tap it down, then we'll get our spirit level again. We'll check it, spirit level later. Straight down, we'll put it on, tap it down. Make sure it's nice and level.
Keep it dead tight and onto the wheel head. Otherwise, if you bring it upwards, it'll take a big chunk out. That's it. It started to move. Okay, I'll hold it. Right, so we're going onto John's tile. There you are, John. There we are. Right.
And that should more or less come up to where our chalk back is there. Okay. If you get too far, that means you've got your joints too thick in between.
So all I did was play for 3 years as far as I was concerned. No, it was ceramics that got me. So when I moved up,
I'm thinking I go up as well or something.
You trim it. Right. You can improve the shape on the outside by just working a bit with your rib. And if you come from, right, are you spinning? Yeah, okay. Are you spinning?
Yeah, just trying to slow it down a bit.
Not just too fast going. Down a bit, that's it. Now just keep it steady. Right.
In here, isn't there, than there is on there.
Put all the excess away. You have to do a full bottom. Yeah. Shut that one. Tell these jokes here, look, they want to correspond to there. What you've done, you've actually got to there, so you're basically
a little bit too high and low.
A little bit out on the gauge, it's got a little bit too high on that. Right, we've got the scores on there, but we've got two people who've got the same score. What we've got some really good scores, and we've done some superb work, a lot of them. But what we've found, we've got two people who've got the top score. I'm not going to tell you the person, but I'm going to show you the two jobs and then you can decide off the two which you'll think is the best one.
So is it supposed to be flush or what?
The water? No, it's meant to be like a
bit of tape.
It's meant to be a tape.
Right, okay. Oh, it's very good.
Thank you. Yep. Gosh, don't tell me decisions.
They're very close, aren't they? No, that one's
the best. That one there?
Yes.
Right. So is that one yours, Antonio? Yeah, yeah, yeah.